in the last 100 years or so since the Industrial Revolution. It's unbelievable what has happened, but that has been the releasing of creative energy by this concept of individual liberty. And why I'm so concerned is I think we're losing that. If you don't have the emphasis and the understanding about the importance of liberty and releasing this energy that is necessary to be creative and prosperous and free, if you lose that, the prosperity will eventually be drained. And I think that's what we're witnessing now. That's why the anger and the frustration on those who have to pay and those who are receiving. And the handwriting is on the wall. Something is happening, and it's not only here in America, but worldwide. So it is a crucial battle. The question is whether, as this financial crisis evolves and gets worse, is going to be only us, and can we reverse it rather easily, or will it be worldwide, and how significant it is? And I think it can be very big. I think it can be worldwide. And the real goal is not partisan politics. The real goal is a revolutionary spirit that pervades all party sentiments. If you think about it in terms of what Keynes was able to do in economics, the climax of the Keynesian revolution is what Nixon said, we're all Keynesians now. In Washington, they're still Keynesians. Hopefully someday we can all say that we all believe in liberty, and that is our goal, and that the people should be responsible for themselves. So that's why the battle that we're engaged in is so significant, and why our task is so important. And this is something that will last for a while. We don't know when the real climax will come. The most encouraging thing to me has been the reception that our views get on college campuses. And some people challenge me on that, and they'll start reciting and say, well, the college kids I know, they're not much interested in this, and they recite all the terrible things that they claim that college kids do. But if you can go to a college campus that is considered a liberal college campus and get maybe 1,000 or 2,000 or more young people out interested, just even to come to listen and being curious about this message, I would say that should be very encouraging. And the whole fact that young people on college campuses can get interested in the Federal Reserve, this is pretty fantastic. And it's so automatic that young people aren't interested in inheriting bad debt and wars that are fought for stupid reasons and we can't afford them. I mean, it to me, there is a real revolutionary spirit going on. And our job is to understand that and participate in it and guide it. We can be opposed to the status quo, and we certainly are. But we also have to have the positive answers for that. For instance, we talked a lot about, I think there was a book written called End the Fed. Did anybody ever hear that?
Yeah!
Of course, we want to end the Fed, and that's what we work for, and we weren't supposed to have central banking, but every country in the world has a central bank, so it's an overwhelming task. Now, if you read carefully at the end of the book, End the Fed, and even back when I was on the Gold Commission, the answer there wasn't to close down in one day the Federal Reserve System. Someday it'll close down when the money quits working and that whole system will collapse. But if we had our chance, we can propose something very positive and actually permit a transformation or a transition, and that is just to legalize competition. You know, it's amazing to me, and I've been very pleased with the enthusiasm and the support, both parties and with the people on this idea that why can't we just know what the Fed is doing? You know, and that's caught attention.